Let's get it.
So we don't need
to know totally
the dead, the little blank conversation part. Cause we are just to have some fun.
Perfect.
Yes. So welcome to some What You Think podcast. This is a very special edition. We are
super
celebrating
special.
Our 1 year technically, even though it's like 1 year
ish
months.
We do everything late, so this is perfect.
Mm-hmm. Basically, we're keeping tempo. So what we're doing today is we're going to interview somebody who is very important to this podcast.
Like
the catalyst. He keeps it popping over here.
Right.
So we have Tory Perry. This was a struggle.
The Tory Perry.
It was a fight for me to get him over here. Like, he don't want to get on this side of the camera. So everybody welcome what would we call him? He's our videographer.
Executive producer.
He's a teacher. He
does pretty much everything. He does the editing. He does
all the credits. When you watch a movie and the credits are rolling, all the shit.
It would say sound engineer,
Key Grip, Dolly.
That's funny.
One of the questions I was already prepared for the interview. So one of the things
set me up, man.
Yeah,
I guess
she's been ready, bro.
You know I'm so unprepared. You gonna see what she got?
That's set up, y'all.
It's not really a setup. It's just that, I want to sing his praises, but I also want to, get his, input on how it has been this first year, because you know me before this.
Right.
You knew me before this, but in coming into the podcast, this is your introduction pretty much to Macko and Preach.
Yeah.
Okay, how has this experience for this first year with the three of us as an accumulator, because you've worked with Macko separately?
Right.
Have you worked with Preach separately?
No, mm-hmm. Not yet. We got some things lined up.
So you've got all of our personalities. What do you think?
He gets to edit it, too.
I mean, man, listen, this is like...
this is dope.
It's good. Okay. It's good. Everything is good. I have nothing bad to say. Just at the beginning, it was like everybody was trying to, do their own thing. And, I heard this through... Was it you? Somebody, they was like, oh, we're trying to do a podcast.
It was on my page. I was asking for a name.
And then at that point, I was just in a creative mode. I was like, let me see what I can do. So then I talked to you, and then you said Macko, then brought Preach on. And then this has evolved into something like...
And just think, a Facebook post, and now he's been stuck with us for over a year. And we ain't no easy pill.
I love it. I like meeting y'all, just coming to hang out with y'all. Because the interaction between y'all, T-Dot keeps everything going.
I'm the mama. If they want me,
she's the mama. But T-Dot,
she's the mama.
She drives everything. She tells us when to meet. She tells us when to go. She brings snacks.
She's kind of the mama. Okay.
Yeah, she's the mama. And T-Dot also keeps the mess going too. Whenever
the mess mama. The mess mama.
Yeah. T-Dot keeps
the theatricals.
T-Dot keeps everything going, then Macko. Macko is the silent instigator.
Yeah, I like this.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Macko's the silent instigator. Like before we start recording, we talk about our the topics or whatever. And then sometimes Macko will be like, well, I'm going to take this side. And we're like, what is... Oh, like two episodes ago, Macko, he'd be making some analogies. And T-Dot, I can see on T-Dot's face, like, what?
And that's the beauty of all of our range. And he gets to, of course, Perry gets... Tory gets to explore and edit. And you just sit back and listen to us just ramble and just be so fucked off. We some fucked off individuals in real life. But then when we put it out there, it just makes sense to us as people. Well, and Tory gets it, too.
What has been, hold on. My bad. Then Preach. Preach.
Oh, my God. Here we go, T-Dog.
Preach adds balance. To these two.
If that's possible.
He does. Preach has balance. Y'all see the on camera type stuff. But me and Matt.
Oh, that's hilarious.
On camera, we just like
the hour or 30 minutes to get started in between. Oh, that's so much. We need to have.
I just told him to fuck, to shut the fuck up. Like, what, like 10 minutes ago, I was telling him to shut the fuck up because he was laughing at me.
Oh, it's always. They go, it is a very bipolar relationship between these two individuals.
Fam. Go, I couldn't look in the. She did not want me to look in the mirror, fam. Who does that?
He turned light skin so quick when he dressed up.
He does. He was sitting over there giving a light skin squint, like.
All right, y'all, look, Pete.
Yeah.
So, T-Dot is always dressed up, right? T-Dot always dressed up. Can I don't get to dress up like this too often, so I feel myself.
Okay. I'm back to Tory.
Back to Tory.
Okay, there we go.
Now, what was you going to say?
So you get to edit behind the scenes. What would you think is probably the most memorable one that you've seen? What stuck out the most? Because you get to see all the episodes.
I think the ones that stand out the most are probably the most memorable is the man weave.
Oh, that was funny.
Y'all need to go watch that. That's one of the first ones. So just scroll back. If you can find that first video, it's easy to start there. I think it's like episode 4 or 5. And then the ones that I like when Mako and Preach, like they was freestyling. I was like, okay, I have to report this. So
that was dope.
That one. And just recently, Mr. Smiley. Who's Mr. Smiley?
Oh, yeah.
That was dope.
Yeah, those are the, I don't know. I just.
Those are the good ones.
I like those.
Hey, Mr. Smiley.
Okay, I have a question. How long have you been into videography and production?
Sure question.
Videography. Maybe about 3 or 4 years.
Really?
That's I mean, just.
It seems like you've been a lifelong.
How did you learn?
Just trial and error, just doing things and seeing YouTube, watching YouTube That's videos. Dope. It's just kind of one of the things that you, I think that a smart man once told me that you have to reinvent yourself every 7 to 10 years.
I like that.
That smart man was Mark Fleming. Yeah. He is Mark Fleming.
Wow.
He said you have to reinvent yourself every 7 to 10 years. That way you don't get complacent or get bored with who you are.
Right.
So, you know, y'all know me as, I've done photos, been doing photography for years now, and then now videos.
So. Okay.
He's what a beast
other,
at it.
What other things do you do? I've heard.
This is, and that's what I was going to say because he posted a video the other day and it just clicked to me. I'm like, of course, me and his big sister are graduating seniors of same class of 91. No shade. But I forgot, like, his video started, what got my attention was you recording your son. His son is a drum major at the great Langston University. Then he posted a video, and I'm like, he does play an instrument. Like, he's just like, he does it all. Like, he plays a saxophone. What all instruments you play?
You know what? I've never actually stopped to count how many instruments I play. I think it would sound really like a douchebag. So I said, how many instruments you play?
And
I
was that's
like,
coming from 17. Somebody who I had to twist their arm to get in front of the camera.
Do this. This is so easy.
I translate very well.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go, Mac.
Keep that thought. He's analyzing me. He's never analyzed me before, so I'm curious to what he's going to say.
What he said is, man, he do all that shit. There ain't really nothing you could do. He quit counting. That means he does more than 5. Because if it was 5, he would say 5. So I'm just going to assume it's at least more than 8. He threw out 17. So we just going to say this dude is a jack of all trades.
He is. I mean,
he's self-taught. Who did you? How did you learn how to play these instruments?
Oh, Mr. Scott.
Who's that?
Edgar Scott, high school band director.
From Millwood
High School. I'm class 94. Mr. Edgar Scott, he was the man. I mean, he ran Millwood. Him and Peggy Kennedy, but
he wouldn't let me in the band.
Edgar Scott.
So you learned, what was the first instrument you learned to play?
Tenor saxophone.
Okay. What is your favorite instrument?
You started out with tenor?
I started out with tenor, but I was 5th grade. Millwood started being in 5th grade. I was 10. And then tenor saxophone was a big instrument.
Right.
And I was carrying it down to the bus stop one day, and it was raining, and my mom went to work, and she saw me stand on the bus stop with this big old instrument. And that day she was like, "Nope, I'm not gonna have my baby carrying that big old instrument." And then I had an alto saxophone. My mama tells that story to this day.
His mama is such a sweetheart. She was, of course, not only just a class mom for me, going to school, but when my baby boy went to Head Start, she was a teacher for my baby boy. And she used to be like, oh, that, because he bad. He bad. And I'd be like, oh, see, every time she told me something, I'm like, he's so bad. And she would still speak life into my baby. Like, that's he ain't bad. Man. He ain't bad.
That's my mom. I love. I'm a mama's boy. I'm not a punk, but I'm still a mama's boy.
That's what I love my mama. Yes. Now, you said you switched from tenor saxophone to alto. What is the difference between the two?
The keys. The alto sax is in E flat. Tenor sax is in B flat.
Visually, so, is it a way that we can recognize someone that plays one?
I mean, tenor sax is bigger. Tenor sax is way bigger.
Okay.
Alto sax is smaller. Think then soprano sax. Think Kenny G.
Which one is like a clarinet? So which one is the one that make the women?
Yeah,
that's the soprano saxophone.
Okay.
So yeah, that's the one.
I play that one.
Okay, so this is what I want to know. You are a band director at Star Spencer now.
Yep.
At the Star Spencer High School. Because you went from Star Spencer to John Marshall and you're back at Star Spencer.
Yeah.
Would you ever want to elevate to the college level of band directing?
At this point in my career, no. I mean, there was a time that I thought I would, but now, this is 20 years in the game for me. In high school, you work 5 days a week, Friday night, you know, a couple of basketball games, but college, you work 6 days a week.
Mm.
You know, you band practice till 11:30 midnight.
You got to ride out your field shows. And then
do all that stuff. And you work summers recruiting. I like my summers off.
I know that's right. I would not be wanting to deal with them horny-ass college kids. No way. Fuck them. Not playing.
They are.
It's a different set of rules. I know. I have college.
Yeah, because it's like they're kids, but yet they're adults.
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of, you want to discipline them, but you can't. Like, dude, you 19. I can't.
Because that's what they tell you when you go to college. Like, there's nobody who's going to make you go to class.
So now I got punched in the face.
Now, right. So you were a drum major.
Yeah.
At the Great Langston University.
What is a drum major for those that don't know?
Who don't know what a drum major is?
There are people that don't.
Drum major is the figure that marches in front of the band with the baton, the backbeat, all that stuff.
Okay, so he was a drum major at Langston University, and now your son is a drum major at Langston University. What does that feel like?
Man, he is the. That makes me proud. I'm the.
Because that's something that doesn't, you know. That, like,
what do you have to do to become the drum major? Expand on how do they choose who's the main stepper?
You try out, but before you try out, the band director, they know who the leaders are.
Right.
You know, most people think that leaders are chosen and all that stuff. You don't have to, you just see how people move.
Right.
And then whoever follows, you see who people follow.
Definitely.
And then, you know, it's just like when you was a teacher, some kids didn't have to say nothing. Mm-hmm. But as soon as he made a move, the other kids did, you're like, oh, okay, he or she.
My cousin was one of the best drum majors LU ever seen. Shout out to Malachi Brown. So I know what an honor it is to be a drum major, but then to have it as a, you know, like legacy.
Malachi, he was drum major at Millwood,
mm-hmm.
and then he was drum major at Langston. I was the next Millwood drum major after
Malachi.
Okay.
That's dope, man.
What are some of the perks that came with being the drum major while you were in college?
Or I think you have to work harder.
It's more work, more responsibility. You know,
okay.
So everybody else gets to go play or relax when band practice over. Drum majors, you gotta get there early, stay late. If somebody forgets to put the uniforms up, you know, you gotta do that stuff.
Are there groupies involved in this?
That's what I was wondering.
I see how you were trying to go. So I do want to get some. I want to ask one. You see, and you were scared.
Yeah, you're right.
I can't do 15 minutes.
Listen, this is how dope he is. I feel like we've only like.
Now you scratch the surface.
A layer. What I want to talk about is that you have when everything clears up and we get back to our regular normal. You and the lovely Courtney Penn Knight have a project coming up.
Courtney,
she is a creative. She is a
so I don't I don't use this word often, but Courtney is dope.
She is dope as fuck.
I mean, her energy, her vibe, just me and Courtney, we
flow. She has a flow.
In our we vibe on the same frequency. That's why a lot of stuff that we do when we put out, even I look at it afterwards and I'm like, this is some good stuff.
Right.
So yeah, we started Oklahoma Art Exchange, which is OAX, and it's to bridge the gap between the arts. So we want to eventually, we want to be like the Oklahoma Arts Council, but for us, you know.
Sorry.
And we're all of this around the same age. Y'all remember BLAC?
That did.
We kind of want to be the BLAC for our age,
for our generation.
So they brought in, you know, dancers and, you know, plays and, you know, but so it's just all art.
Yeah, you know,
so
we, you know, poets,
photographers, rappers, painters, everybody.
And she's such a creative. And so when I see that y'all two linked up, I'm like, that just makes
sense.
So much sense. Like, it's stupid. So I knew you were an art exchange, but I wanted to explain what it meant. Because of growing up in our era, we were always into some things of that nature. Like, you had to be doing something creative. I was more of a majorette, skirt twirler. I had the short skirt thing.
I thought you were going to say twerker.
I thought you said
squirter. I was more like the color guard. But I mean, like, because growing up, like, I'm sure you participated in pageants.
Yeah.
You had to do you had to be the escort in pageants. So I grew up in pageants. I got kicked out of the pageant. I slapped Sydney.
That's a whole, you don't have to say
name. I heard that name in.
She passed away.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so I got kicked out. So, I mean, growing up with my Aunt Clara, I had to be involved in all that kind of stuff. So we. Now, when I look at these generations coming up, I'm like, they're missing so much.
Mm-hmm.
And when I seen the art exchange, I'm like, that is a way to usher back in some of the arts that we grew up being forced to embrace, but then we appreciate those arts. So
let me ask you this. Can you sing, Tori?
Oh.
You know I can sing. Oh, I can sing.
Well, yeah, we just transitioned.
I retired.
I bet he got a...
Okay, so ladies.
Still a chair.
Oh, man.
Tori, are you single? Tell us your status. Are you single?
Yeah, I'm single.
Okay, so ladies, he's a single, eligible bachelor. He can play a bunch. He's like a tall
prince. He know how to work his hands. Yeah.
He's like a tall, masculine prince. If you ever want to.
Damn, y'all.
God, ladies.
So, ladies.
He got to go back and run it. But anyway,
if
y'all.
A man in your life that's a born leader.
And a creative.
Over 6 feet tall.
You won't get bored.
Plays 29 or 30 instruments.
And word on the streets.
And he can sing.
Yeah.
He wears a size 19 shoe.
And on a real note, like, he has a really giving heart. I would have spoken to Star Spencer, man, and those students gravitated towards him. The teachers speak highly of him. Like,
I can definitely tell Mr. Purvey is a lot of people's favorite teacher.
Straight up, man.
Yeah. He has to be.
A real dope. Real dope dude.
All right. Well, we definitely appreciate you, Tori, for letting us interview, even though you act like it was a damn major surgery.
Now, thank
trust
you.
Us.
And
he is performance surgery.
We only scraped the surface.
Like, we didn't get
I think
anywhere.
We need an hour.
We need two episodes. So
we might get him
thank y'all
lives.
For tuning in. Make sure you check out him and Courtney Penn Knight with their art exchange.
Oklahoma Art Exchange.
OEX. OEX. And OEX.
OAX.
Yeah.
Sorry.
The man.
We doing some stuff.
Bang, bang.
That's
bang.
Why he the creative. And we just sit over here. So yeah, and OctiDot.
I'm Preach.
I'm Mac O.
Thank y'all for tuning in. That was dope. Tori, I don't know why you wanna take me through it like that. Like,
and this my thing, like, we could have really asked. I should have been more prepared.
You should have been. You always should.
I know. I mean, we could have had some. We could have got.
You could have got some.
Some good better stuff.
Some deep stuff.
But that was good. No, that was good. But I'm saying the fact is,
to the gun range and his passion about guns and
he just got to see
the guns, the investments, the wisdom.
Yeah, he has so much. Pimping.